Hello and welcome to my second or third, depending on how you count, Utopian Dream Week video. I already did my first impression swatches and comparisons. I did a look yesterday and today I'm coming at you with another look. Let's talk about multichromes for a second here. So I'm going to do a look with Blitz Sextreme today, but before that I wanted to quickly address multichromes with you. So I bought my first multichromes in... I want to say 2017 from a small indie brand called Donna's Cosmetics, who had just released multichromes in the year, I think, before, so around 2016, and they were something completely new on the market. I think Donna's was really the first brand to ever release multichromes, and I got wind of that relatively quickly, so I was like, okay, duochromes I love, multichromes should like just blow my fucking mind. So I bought a couple of sample sizes of their multichromes, and then they got here, I swatched them, I was like, mind blown. I was like, what is this? This is magic, I love it. So then I did a video or two, and after that I basically never pulled these multichromes back out from my drawers. And when Cleona and a bunch of others started releasing multichromes, I had less than zero interest in purchasing them. I was tempted, but then I reminded myself, why are you never using the multichromes that you already have? And then I forced myself to think about it, and I figured out why I don't like, well, it's not that I don't like multichromes, I just think they are a finicky little thing. Here's the thing with multichromes. Multichromes are great in theory, just like communism. You know, works great in theory. Let's all be equal, let's all be happy, let's all have equal incomes and, you know, have all the equal opportunities. Great in theory, not so much in practice. Same with multichromes. The thing with multichromes is, there are a couple of things actually. First of all, if you are talking about a multichrome which shifts across the spectrum, let's say you have a multichrome that shifts all the way from like red to like green on the spectrum, which is a little bit what we're dealing with today, by the way. How do you combine that? Like, what kind of eyeshadow do you put through your crease? What goes well with a lime green and a hot pink coral red? Very few eyeshadows. And don't tell me neutrals, because even neutrals, there is a lot to go around with neutrals, so what kind of neutral do you throw to your crease? Second of all, a lot of these more jeweled type multichromes, like the really deep, rich shifts, are build up on a very dark base. So once you start blending them out, and especially the multichromes that I had, like first generation Donna's multichromes, they had this extremely dark, I want to say black matte base. As soon as you started to blend them out, they would just turn muddy and really, really dark. And lastly, how do you combine multichromes with the rest of your attire? Let's say we're talking about those multichromes that shift across the spectrum again. What kind of clothes do you put on? Unless you're going to like stick to black and white, it would be it's really hard to pair them with clothing. And it's also really hard to pair them with lipstick. I don't know whether you've thought about it, but I've always really struggled like pairing multichromes that shift across the spectrum with a lipstick, because what do you put on that goes with all the shifts? And don't tell me a neutral. No, we're talking about different types of nudes though. Like, is it a warm toned nude, a more pink toned nude, a more brown toned nude, or something that needs a bit more taupe? It's a whole new science figuring out how to combine multichromes. And that was the reason I sort of like stepped away from them, and I thought I would enjoy the idea, but I wouldn't buy them. And then last year when Pat put a multichrome in the Divine Rose 2 palette, I was super excited, but at the same time a little bit apprehensive, until I got the eyeshadow, because VRS Extraterrestrial turned out to be a very easy eyeshadow to work with, and one that is very easy to wear on its own. And that is when I figured out that a multichrome works for me, like those like really, really shifty multichromes. I'm not talking about multichromes that shift on like a certain type of the spectrum. If you have like a blue-green multichrome, that's relatively easy. You're like in one part of the spectrum. Those are easy to combine, those are easy to, you know, think of how you're going to, what you're going to do with them. I'm talking about the like the ones that Pat has put out, which shift across quite a wide range in the spectrum. Those are the ones that are really hard. So last year I figured out, after playing around with Extraterrestrial for a while, that the best way that multichromes work for me is when I use them as a one and done eyeshadow. So I don't bother thinking what I'm going to put through my crease. And I also try to figure out what exactly I want from the multichrome. If I want the more pink side of the spectrum to come through, I will put it over a glitter base because then the pink becomes a bit more intense. And if I want the like more like forest green, like sort of muddy green to come through, I will not put a dark base. And then I will combine that with the rest of my clothing and with the lipstick depending on which shift I'm trying to pull through. So that was my very long-winded introduction to Blitz Sextreme. And the very simple look that we're going to do today, because I'm just going to start off with Blitz Sextreme and I'm going to just blend it out through my crease. I'm going to see how it goes, and if I feel like there is an appropriate matte eyeshadow to blend it out and like blow it out through my crease, I will go for that. Otherwise, I'm just going to stick to Blitz Sextreme, and that will be it for my lids. Now, before I start, one of you asked me to compare the Naked Blush shade from the Divine Rose 2 palette, so this one here, with Secret Eden from Utopian Dream, which, as I mentioned, one of my favorites, that beautiful dusty rose over here. I think they're really different shades because the Naked Blush shade is definitely more of a peach tone, like a peachy nude, whereas Secret Eden is more of like a rosy dusty pink nude. I already mentioned the difference in the texture and formula between VRS Extraterrestrial and Blitz Sextreme, so I'm not going to spend too much time on it. If you would like to hear my thoughts on that, I will refer you to my first impression video on the Utopian Dream palette, but basically they are a completely different formula. Sextraterrestrial is in her VR formula and Blitz Sextreme is a metallic eyeshadow. I'm very curious to put it on my eye, so without further ado, grabbing a brush like this one. So this is the Worker Pro from Sonia G. It's the type of brush that you can both pack and blend with. So I'm going to take this shade. I've already applied my eyeshadow base, by the way. And I'm not even sure that I'm going to apply any of the Artistry Wand, because like I said, it will really depend on the shifts that I'm getting from this shade and what I would like to have a bit more coming through today. Maybe we'll just try it on part of my lid to see what happens. But basically, I start here, the closest to my lash line, and then as I go upwards, I'm going to start blending out the shade. So this is blending out not too bad. I'm going to start packing it a bit more onto the lid. And I feel like this already has quite a bit of impact. I think VR's Extraterrestrial is somewhat softer in its impact because it's in the VR formula. It also blends out really beautifully, so that is not a concern that you should have with VR's Extraterrestrial. It blends out just as easily. So as you can see, when I blend the shade out, you get a bit more of that like murky, like swamp green, swampy green. But I think I personally don't feel the need to put another matte through my crease to blend this shade out. I think this is fine for me. Because the whole point of a multichrome is that it shifts in different colors so that you don't have to put different colors on your eyelid in order to create this very interesting effect. So when I look at the eyeshadow straight on, I'm getting a lot of that fiery red peachy shade, and when I turn my head, I see the swampy green coming through. It's a really pretty shade. I think when it comes to like the tones and the shifts, I like this one better than VRS Extraterrestrial, because VRS Extraterrestrial is more cool toned. But that is just a personal preference, and it's not to say that I don't like Sextraterrestrial. I adore Sextraterrestrial. I'm sorry, I think a certain cat wants to come in. Are you here to take a nap? Enjoy. Yes, my love, do you have a lot of things to say? To share with the world? Tell us all about your adventures. Did you get your ass kicked again? I shared a photo of Bruce on Instagram recently, because he's like his nose area is all full of like scabs. I think he's fighting with a cat that apparently has like a super like flawless aim, like going right for the nose every time. So to me, this eyeshadow is applying pretty impactfully as it is. I don't feel the need to apply a glitter glue underneath it to make it pop. However, we like doing science on this channel, so I am going to apply the tiniest bit of the Artistry Wand. just taking my finger, and I think I'm going to put the glitter base right here onto the inner portion of the lid towards the middle, and I'm going to apply Sextreme over there, over the glitter glue type product, just to see how it compares. And I think I'm just going to also take my finger for that to deliver the absolute most impact. Exactly as I expected. I don't know if it's coming across on camera, I hope it is, but what happens when you put the glitter base underneath these types of eyeshadows is that, like, the more pink red flip comes through more vibrantly. So to me, I feel like here, like, the peachy red fiery duochrome is coming through more strongly than the green. So I will actually leave it like this because I want to have the murky green in my outer corners to imitate a little bit like that darkening effect towards the outer side of the eye. So depending on what you want to pull through from this eyeshadow, you should just apply or not apply the artistry wand. But I think this looks beautiful as it is on its own. I'm going to take a smaller type of brush and pull Sextreme onto the lower lash line as well. And finally, for my inner corner, I am going to take a little bit of this shade and this shade. So Cosmic Bloom and the Skin Show something something shade, to mix a little bit the two shades so that I can create a good, I think, inner corner highlight that would fit this shade. I'm just sort of like dipping back between the two shades to create this. So there you have it, the longest rambling in the world to just apply one eyeshadow on my eyelids. But that is pretty much the take-home message that I have from this video when it comes to these more complex types of multichromes with a very dark base, such as Sextreme and Sextraterrestrial. My personal advice for you would be just stick to one eyeshadow, do a one eyeshadow type of look, and you cannot really go wrong. And the reason I like Pat's eyeshadow so much for this is because it's crucial that when you have an eyeshadow like this, you can blend it out and it still looks flattering. And that is what I like about both of her multichromes. You can blend them out and they will look flattering and they will not turn into a blackened muddy mess on your eyelids. If you have any thoughts, suggestions and advice when it comes to using multichromes, please do share them with the rest of us in my comment section. I can't wait to chat with you there. Now I will bid you goodbye because I'm already a little bit late for work. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye!